So, welcome dear students for today's session on system programming. And today we are going to start with the unit 3, introduction to compiler. So, to start with, let me tell you the contents of unit 3. So, unit 3 is about the compilers, and these are the contents that we are going to study in this particular unit. So, the phase structure of compiler, the entire compilation process. So, here we are now going to study different type of translators, and you know that compiler is also a kind of translator. So what is compiler, what is the design in terms of phases of the compiler, and entire compilation process, that is the first part of our unit 3. Then we are going to study lexical analyzer, wherein we'll study the role of lexical analyzer, input buffering, specification of the tokens, recognition of the tokens, design of the lexical analyzer using uniform symbol table, and lexical errors is the point that we are going to discuss at the end. And finally, the last point is based on the lex specification, generalization of the lexical analyzer by lex, for which we also have a practical assignment. So these are the contents of unit 3 of system programming under the heading Introduction to Compilers. So what are the outcome of learning this particular unit? This is what we shall see now. So once you complete this unit, at the end of this unit, you will be able to use the tool lex for generation of the lexical analyzer. So you will understand the concept of compilation, the lexical analyzer, and using the tool. Okay, because we have a practical assignment based on lex and ax. So using this tool of lex, you will be able to generate lexical analyzer. So this is the outcome for after you learn this particular unit. Okay, fine. So I hope this is clear. Now let us see the today's session outline. So we shall study the phase structure of compiler and the entire compilation process. We shall study the role of lexical analyzer, and finally we shall study some of the basic terminologies related to the lexical analyzer. Right, so this is the outline for today's session, and with that let us come to the compiler and the phases of compilation. So before we start with that, let us have a quick discussion over what is a compiler, what is the definition of the compiler, and what is the compilation process. So dear students, you all know what is a compiler. In fact, you have been using so many high level programming language, and what is the role of a compiler in this programming language, you are completely aware of. It is a kind of translator, right? So as you have a language translator, you know, suppose you have a conference, international conference, where there are participants globally from various countries, and speaking their own typical local languages, and in that case you need a translator who will translate the language for us. For example, somebody speaking in Chinese and we Indian don't understand. So if there is a language translator, every word or every sentence spoken by the person can be converted into the English, Hindi language. So that is like a translator who converts one language into another. Similarly, in our computer world, as you know that our computer only understands the low level language, that is the machine language. And we as a programmer, software developer, we are writing our program in high level languages, right? So always there is a need of a translator who will translate the program, source programs written in this high level languages into your machine level language. So looking at the definition, a compiler is a program which translates a high level source program into a low level object program. In the last unit, we have seen in the section of linker, loader, what is the object program, what is the source program, and all those things. So the compiler is a program that converts high level language to the assembly language. Right. Similarly, assembler is a program that converts assembly language to the machine level language. User writes a program in C language, for example, which is a high level language. So we need a C compiler which will compile the program and translate it into the assembly program. Right. And along with that, the next phase will be an assembler, who is responsible to translate the assembly program into the object file, or we call the machine code. And then we studied in the unit two also the linker and the loader functions. Okay, so you all know now that linker tool is used to link all the parts of the program together for machine execution as a execution by your CPU. And the loader is responsible to load all the data, that is the data and the instructions into the main memory so that it could be executed. So this was all the things that we studied in the earlier lecture and a kind of review. Now, you all know that preprocessor, interpreter, assembler, linker, loader, cross compiler, and all this are nothing but a category, or we can under category of translators, and they all work together in as a system softwares and carry out all the task of convergence, linking, loading, so that for a programmer it becomes very easy. He just has to learn the language with the correct syntax and write the code in logical way, and rest of the thing required like memory address association, compilation, conversion, linking, loading, all this task is done for the programmer in the backend by all this system softwares that we have already studied. That is the preprocessor, which is generally considered as a part of compiler, is a tool that produces input for the compiler. Then you know we have studied interpreter, we have studied the difference between the interpreter and the compiler. They are having the same role of translating high level language to low level. We have assembler to translate assembly language to machine code. Linker is a program that links and merges various object files together, and loader loads the program into the main memory, right? And cross compiler, a compiler that runs on a platform A, and it is capable of generating executable code for platform B, is called as cross compiler, which we already saw, right? So the source to source compiler, that is a compiler that takes the source code of one programming language and translate it into the source code of another programming language, is called as source to source compiler, right? So these are all the different I have named them as cousins of compiler. So and this is how they are working together in the background for whatever source code that we as a programmer is giving or writing in our computer system. So it goes through all these different phases through this different type of system softwares, and at the end of every processing, some kind of file is generated, which is given as an input to another, and that file is again input to the next phase. Right. So I hope this complete, you know, the process is clear to you, that from source code, how finally the program is converted to the machine code and loaded into the memory. So this is the entire process. Right. So I hope it is clear to you. If it is clear with this, we can start with the further phases of compiler. Now again, there are two phases of compiler, if you remember, analysis phase and synthesis phase. front end of the compiler that is about analysis, and back end we can say that this is nothing but the synthesis phase, and we have studied this very much in the details in our unit number 1. So compiler, this is just a kind of review. A compiler can have many phases and number of passes. We already studied 2-pass compiler, right? So sorry, that was the assembler. This is the compiler. Again, it has similar phases, like we have the assembler, that is the analysis phase and the synthesis phase. So it has multiple phases and multiple passes. So pass, you know that a pass refers to the traversal of the compiler through the entire program, right? So right from step number, block number 1 to end, for every pass we go through start to the end. Whereas phase of the compiler is a distinguishable stage. Okay, one part, one block, one module is the phase which is responsible to carry out some specific task and provide the output to the next stage. Okay, so which takes the input from the previous state, it processes that particular input and does its own role of compilation and yields the output that can be used as a input for the next stage. So a pass can have more than one phases. Now here the diagram depicts the 2 phases. Again, in exam also you may get question on explain the phases of compilation, where you need to draw this diagram and explain the both the phases with the introduction that you have seen in the earlier slide, right? So here this analysis phase is referred to as the front end, and the synthesis phase is referred to as a back end, right? So backend constitute of lexical analyzer, semantic analyzer, syntax analyzer, and intermediate code generation. Now we are going to study all these phases in detail. That is what is the contents of our unit 3. So for now you understand that the phases of compiler is divided into 2, that is the front end and back end. And in front end, what we it consists of lexical analyzer, semantic analyzer, syntax analyzer, and intermediate code generator. And after that, whatever process remains, that is done at the synthesis phase, for which the input is this particular intermediate code generation, and the output is our final outcome that we are looking for, that is our machine code, right? So this is what are the phases of compiler that we have studied. And those phases of the compiler can also be shown with this particular diagram showing all these phases. Okay, so this phase, as we have seen, this is the analysis phase, and remaining phase, which I have shown in the yellow color, is nothing but the synthesis phase. And of course, we are going to require certain data structures, like we have studied for the assembler and the linker and loader, that during each phase, this data, various data structures associated, we fill in the information and we carry out the process, right? Okay, so I hope that this 2 phases of compiler is very much clear to you, and you are able to answer the question if it is asked what are the phases of the compiler. Along with the diagram, you can explain that. Now, coming to the first phase, now we shall study each and every phase in details. Now again, dear students, we have already studied the TOC subject in the last semester, and as you know that TOC is a prerequisite. TOC data structures are the prerequisite for studying system programming. So this, you know, lexical analyzer, why I'm talking about TOC now, because this particular lexical analyzer phase of the compiler, okay, it is implemented using DFA, deterministic finite automata, right? So the lexical analyzer, what it is the first phase of compiler. It is also known as the scanner. It converts the input program into the sequence of tokens. Okay, so now see this analogy which is given to understand what is lexical analyzer. It is like a scanner. Means in this pass, what happens, whatever source program is provided, it will just scan the entire source program line by line, and it is going to simply identify the tokens that we have to use in our source program and send the tokens to the next phase. So this particular phase, uska kaam kya hai? Just to scan the entire program to identify all the tokens. Now I'm talking about tokens. So what is this tokens? Okay. So tokens, it is, now we can say a lexical token is a sequence of characters that can be treated as a single logical entity. Okay. So sequence of characters. We will see in details what are tokens, what are non-tokens, and how this particular lexical analyzer, it will take us each and every token and send it to the next stage, that is the parser, okay, for the syntax analysis. So lexical analyzer, it takes one statement, okay, and it converts to or identify various tokens in that particular statement, right? And then it gives this tokens to the next phase of your compilation, right? So I hope now this thing is clear to you. So let us go more into the details now. So as we know that it reads a program, lexical analyzer, it reads a program, it converts it into the tokens, right? It converts a stream of lexemes into a stream of tokens. Now I'm going to explain you all these terms, don't worry. Tokens are defined by regular expressions which are understood by the lexical analyzer. It also removes white spaces and comments. So just 2 minutes back I told you there are some tokens and some are non-tokens, right? So here there are two important roles of lexical analyzer. Like, it need to identify the tokens and send them to the next phase. At the same time, it needs to remove the white spaces and the comments. Why? Because this white spaces, comments, these are called as the non-token. So for example, given a statement, like you can see here, this is one statement, x colon equal to z plus 5. So if I tell you that which are the tokens and the non-tokens. Now for example, here we have 5 tokens. X is a token, equal sign is a token, z is a token, plus is a token, y is the token. If there was a space in between, right? So that space is not considered as a token. Or if we write a comment to describe for documentation in our source code, we do write comments. That is also ignored by the lexical analyzer. So when it reads our source code line by line, it will correctly identify the tokens and send the tokens. Okay, and it will remove the white spaces, it will remove the comments, okay, from the source code. So this is how your lexical analyzer works. It correlates the error message with the source program. It helps you to expand your macros also if it is found in the source program. So there also the role of lexical analyzers come into the picture. So now, here, to tell you clearly what are the tokens. So tokens are all the keywords, all the operators, all the constants, all the identifiers, and all the special symbol used in the program. Okay, so all these are considered as token by your lexical analyzer. Okay, and all the other symbols, like I said, blank spaces or tab or new line, you know, comments, all these things will be considered as a non-token. So I hope now you are very much clear that what do we mean by tokens and what is the function of lexical analyzer. It will simply scan through your source program, identify the tokens, and send it to the next phase and remove the white space or the tabs or such kind of non-tokens. Now please note here that the semicolon, colon, operators, these are also considered as the tokens, right? Here it is written, operators are the tokens, special symbols are the tokens, right? Keywords, constants are the tokens. So I hope now the concept of token is very much clear to you all. Yeah. Now, there was another word I used in the earlier PPT was about lexemes and patterns. So token is clear to you. What is pattern? A set of strings in the input for which the same token is produced as an output. This set of string is described by the rule called a pattern associated with the token. Okay, see, now in computation, you know that we follow certain patterns. There could be even a use of pattern. Okay, like here, for example, letters followed by letters and digit. So this becomes a pattern. And in a given string, this pattern may be there in the repeated fashion. So this kind of things will come under the category of pattern, right? So tokens are clear to you. Patterns are clear to you. Patterns means a certain set of string, okay? But it has some particular meaning, or you can identify that pattern in the given set of lines or the program. Okay, so all the, for example, all the letters which are followed by letter and then a digit, if you find such kind of string, we call it as a pattern, right? And next is lexeme. A sequence of characters in the source program that is matched by the pattern for the token. Okay, this means that again, this is a set of strings which matches the given pattern. Okay, so for example, int a, first string int, again it is a pattern because it is a set of integers. Lexeme is nothing but it is which matches with the pattern. So here it is a very simple example. So it is also a lexeme is also here an integer. Whereas what is a token here? What is a token here? Anybody? Semicolon, a, constant, variables, all these are the tokens, right? Now here, if I say A star, so it becomes a pattern. A star means one or more occurrence of A. Okay, so that becomes a pattern. So you understand what I mean by tokens, patterns and lexemes. Now, coming to the role of lexical analyzer. So again, you may have a small question based on this particular topic that explain the role of lexical analyzer, right? So in that case, you should explain the points along with the diagram. This is the diagram which explains the role of your lexical analyzer. So as you can see here, there is a lexical analyzer for which the input is the source program. As an output from lexical analyzers are nothing but the tokens which are sent to the next phase, which is the parser. When the parser needs the next token, it will request the lexical analyzer. Then lexical analyzer will send the next token to the parser. Okay, along with it, other associated data structures which are used, like we have seen the data structures used for assembler in the linker and loader, because whatever is the role of this particular phases, it will identify tokens and all those things, and they have to be put in the symbol table, okay, because it stores the symbols and identifiers and labels, right? So this is the table which is associated in this particular phase of lexical analyzer. So we can say that lexical analyzer is the first phase of compilation. It reads the input characters and it produces as an output a sequence of tokens. These tokens are given to the parser, okay, and a parser will carry out the syntax analysis. Secondly, it strips out from the source program all the comments, all the white spaces in form of blank, tab, new line. In fact, a new line is also considered as a non-token. Remember that. So these are the main two things. First is identifying the token and sending to the parser. Second is to remove from the source program all the non-tokens like comments, blanks, white spaces, tabs, new line characters. Okay. Last, it also correlates the error messages from the compiler with the source program. Okay, so if there is certain error message, it will also find out what is the error, and based on that it may need to again read the line and or send the error message to the user, and when the programmer make the changes again, it will identify the token and send to the next phase. So this is how your parser is performing its function, to scan the source code, analyze it and generate the token and send it to the parser. I hope that it is very much clear to you. And then declaration of the error is also the part. Okay, so if you get a question, draw the phases or explain the function of a lexical analyzer, please do draw this particular diagram and explain with the diagram, right? So thank you so much. This was about today's introductory section session on unit 3 and based on the compilers, right? So if you have anything to ask, you can ask me here.